Vsauce! I am the great Gonzo, and this... Rizzo, the episode has started. What are you doing?
Oh, I'm just gathering up some leftovers. I had a light lunch.
Well, Vsauce is here now.
Oh, well, if we have that, why didn't you say so? I'll get some chips. I love Vsauce.
I'm talking about Vsauce, the YouTube channel. Look.
Sorry. Hello there, I am Rizzo. Proceed.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I assume you've come to hear about the mystery of the Quicksilver case.
Oh, the Quicksilver case!
Are you finished?
Yeah, sorry.
All right, the story here begins with two detectives, Jake Roper and Matthew Santoro.
I don't get it. How could anyone move that fast?
I don't know, partner, but we gotta figure out how, because someone got hurt. Not the kind of hurt you get better from.
Have you had a look at the Quicksilver file yet?
Quicksilver, eh?
There's a witness in interrogation if you want to get in there and do your thing.
Quicksilver is a very interesting comic book character. He's fast, really fast. According to Marvel, he can go at Mach 10, which is 2.1 miles every second. He could run around the planet in 3.5 hours. At that speed, if he were to hit you, it would be the same as being smacked by a large oil tanker. It would be messy. But in this case, our suspect didn't run into a person, oh no. We need to find out what would happen if something moving that quickly, pushing that much air out of the way, were to run by you. What if Quicksilver ran past you?
With Jake now firmly on the case and a witness in hand, it seemed like everything was going to go smoothly.
Oh, I'd love a smoothie.
I said smoothly, not smoothie.
Bummer.
Oh, the interrogation is about to start.
I'm gonna get some popcorn.
Why am I not surprised to see you here, Constantine?
I don't know, maybe because you read scripts?
This is no time for laughs.
Of course not. We are working with the Muppets.
Tell me what you know!
I cannot.
Why not?
I lost my script.
Eric, could I get it? Thank you. Top of page 5, right there.
Okay, let's see, where are we here? Ah, yes. I will not tell you anything because I am frog, not rat.
I'm sorry, what did he just say about rats?
It was nothing. Keep eating.
Okay.
Just, what did you see?
Yes. I felt a gust of wind and saw a quick flash of blue go by. That is all I know.
That's actually great. You can go.
I still get my per diem, no?
No.
And they call me criminal.
What Constantine said actually makes a lot of sense. Quicksilver will be moving at such incredible speeds, 11,146 feet per second, that he would only be in our field of view for 83 microseconds to 1 millisecond. It takes 13 milliseconds for the brain to process what the eye sees. So by the time you'd have registered Quicksilver, he'd already be 145 feet past you, and you'd have only seen a slight blue tint, if anything at all. Not to mention that going 10 times the speed of sound would cause a shockwave to form in front of him. The air around him would be compressed 5.7 times and would heat up to 752 degrees Fahrenheit, almost 3 times the boiling point of blood. Speaking of blood, at that temperature, your blood would become a supercritical fluid, having properties of both liquid and gas, and it would start to ooze out of your body. Now, this would only occur if you were 4 inches or closer to a full-speed Quicksilver. But there's gotta be something that I'm breezing by.
With that information, Jake was making headway, but he still was missing one piece of the puzzle, a piece that only one scientist could give him.
Huh.
Rizzo, move.
Yeah.
All right, what do you got for me? Brilliant! Yes! As Beaker so eloquently put, the air surrounding Quicksilver will be traveling at 6,311 miles per hour.
Now, to put that into perspective, a Category 5 tornado, which is as high as the Fujita tornado scale goes, says that at that point, cars will be flung over 330 feet, houses will be ripped out of the ground, and all manner of destruction will occur. And that is with wind speeds at 318 miles per hour, almost 20 times less than Quicksilver's. However, the incredible wind speed would pick up almost everything in his path. Things as small as pebbles, sand, and coins would be thrown around with as much kinetic energy as a bullet. So you wouldn't have to be close to Quicksilver to bear witness to and become a potential victim of the death and destruction that would be left in his wake.
How did it go?
Well, we solved it, partner. If Quicksilver were to run right by you, he would not only do an incredible amount of damage to you, but also to the surroundings due to all the projectiles he would pick up with his immense wind speed.
Now comes the hard part of actually catching him. Also, we got a new case. 10 comic book characters inspired by real people.
New case, huh? Let's go to Fozzie's Comedy Club, grab a nightcap, and then we'll go to your channel to solve that one.
Sounds good.
Waka, this way.
Good one.
Oh boy, hey, I ain't feeling so good.
Well, of course not. You just sucked the cheese out of 15 grilled cheese sandwiches.
Yeah, well, you're living your line. So what happened to Matthew and Jake? Did they catch their guy?
That, Rizzo, is a story for another time.
Oh.
And as always, thank you for watching.
Yeah, so where you wanna go for dinner?
Oh, you are unbelievable.
Well, come on, thank you.
Okay.
You bye.